An Arizona school district making the bold decision to be transparent and let the public know of potential COVID outbreaks. Chandler Unified, the first to make that commitment as the district lays out its roadmap to return to the classroom. Adam Waltz spoke to board members who tried to make the best decision with a clear division between what parents and teachers each wanted. Adam?
And Steve, it took 6 hours to listen and decide what they felt was the best plan for reopening. Now, while many teachers are apprehensive, some parents are just itching to get their kids back into the classroom.
We would send them tomorrow without masks if we could.
Frustration mounting for one Chandler Unified parent over remote learning, who says teachers are great, but tech issues are causing headaches.
Frustration from my son, who's always made A's in math and it's very sharp, but it's hard to teach geometry from a video recording.
Wednesday night, Chandler School District board members voted 3-2 in favor of a plan for Chandler students to return to classrooms. Board member Dave Evans wanted to vote no, but voted yes after talking to individual school principals.
Every single one of those principals said their kids were getting farther behind.
On the other side, Lindsay Love explains her no vote.
I felt that it was inconsiderate of our families who wanted that consistency and were asking us to honor our agreement to remain online for the first quarter and explore in-person options for the second quarter.
In the plan, grades will be staggered in their return. Preschool to second graders will return September 14th, third to sixth graders return September 21st, and seventh through 12th graders on October 13th, the official start of the second quarter.
It's not that I don't trust our phenomenal staff at Chandler. I think that maybe we might be biting off a bit more than we can chew.
In order to return, parents must sign a disclosure agreement that they will not enter the school. And if their child shows symptoms of COVID-19, that student must be picked up within an hour. On top of that, the district voted to publicly report their own COVID-19 data via an online dashboard, the first district we know of to do so.
The reality is we need families and staff to understand what the reality of this is, and we just have to make sure that they have the opportunity to make those decisions.
Chandler Unified didn't say exactly what that dashboard would look like or what specific number will be on it, but they did say that it will be up and running by September 14th. In Chandler, Adam Waltz, ABC 15 Arizona.